This is a special treat, guys. We have Anthony Almada with us. He is the founder and the owner of Atargo, a carbohydrate. Now, this is a body modification world. A lot of people here are athletes. I'm in the body modification world, and everybody here has some sort of achievement that they're looking for, whether it be physical or the way they look. Anthony has the best carb on the market, and he's going to tell us a little bit about why it's the best.
Well, we define the best as actually having studies in humans that use the actual product, muscle biopsies. Don't feel good, but that's the way to tell how many carbs you have in your muscles. You've done how quickly it gets in the blood, how quickly it gets out of the stomach, and then recovery after. So the most important thing to be mindful of is no matter what kind of training you're doing, if it's intense, even if you're on a 2% carb diet, the main fuel that you're burning during intense training is carbohydrate, period. Even on a keto diet.
Question for you. Intensity, what would be the level of intensity? What does that mean? And then I'd like you to talk a little bit about clinical research. I know you guys, we bring that up a lot at Atargo, but when I go to these other booths, nobody's talking to me about clinical research. Nobody's talking to me about some of the things you are. Maybe you can explain why.
Well, let's start backwards. So for us, quality is defined by studies in humans on the actual product, and ideally, it's done at a university where they don't have a conflict of interest. It's not done in some guy's gym or some warehouse. So you get experts doing the testing rather than some guy who just handled a ruler for the first time and measured this. It doesn't work.
Is that cheap to do? Is it cheap to do? I mean, guys, you're dumping money into that, right?
Well, I would say that it's far less expensive than people led to believe. In our first two studies we did at EAS, they were $5,000 and $15,000. Now, they aren't that cheap anymore. That was back in the 90s.
Sure.
But you could spend $30,000 to $50,000 on one study, pay it out over six months, and that's very manageable for almost every company here.
Well, and what if the results don't come back the way you want? So let's say you did do the study, you did pay for it, but you can't use it. You guys can.
Well, that's the reason why more and more companies are going to private research centers. So if the results aren't positive, they bury the data.
And those are the kind of companies that you'll go on and they're actually advertising supplements and then giving you the research done on them, right?
Well, but still, from our research and looking at products, only about 1 out of 1,000 products on the shelf in any type of nutritional, from probiotic to botanicals for joint pain, to sports nutrition, have even one published study in humans.
So what Anthony's saying, guys, for how I'm taking it is, he came out with a product, said it's amazing carb. He paid a lot of money, lots relative, to have it tested to prove that it works. Then he got a booth in a place and telling everybody, hey, look this amazing thing I have. Other people have done something similar, but they didn't do the testing, they didn't spend the money, and so they're giving you an opinion. Anthony's here giving you fact and can show you the research. Is that correct?
Well, they wouldn't be my facts. They're facts gathered by the researchers.
And you're just repeating the facts.
We're reporters.
I love it. He's a okay, and how intense, if somebody, from my perception, when you go cycling, I've been on there and the girls are screaming, go, 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 sweat, 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 sweat. And their accountability on whether they did good is how much they sweat and if they're sore and stuff. And from my perception, they're losing fat and muscle because they don't have enough carbs, but they're afraid of carbs. What would you say to a 140-pound girl trying to get down to 120? She's cycling every day, we'll say 5 days a week for an hour, she's killing it. How much of a target would that girl take, and when would she take it?
Well, we could talk about it, carbs in general, but the interesting thing about like spin cycling is that the major fuel being burned in that type of training is carbohydrate. And so you can measure by the pool, how big is the pool of sweat beneath me, or how long does it take to clean the bike after, or my heart rate. But it's very interesting if you actually were to look inside the muscle and see how much carbs have been burned. There's a lot of carbs being burned, and actually a lot of the fat that's being burned, and a girl that's been going to spin for a while, a lot of that fat being burned is fat stored in the muscle, not fat on their hips, not in their belly. It's actual intramuscular fat like marbling of a steak. And so the perception is that you'll be burning the kind of fat that you want while you're training. That the actual reality is most of fat burning that happens that is of interest to people in sculpting their physique is what happens in the afterburn after they stop training.
Yes. So you basically fuel your workout and have your carbs when you're intensely working, and then afterwards when your heart rate is low, you wouldn't want to have a bunch of high carbs and you just stay in your fat burning zone and let your body burn fat all day.
But you would want to take carbs also after to replace, because one of the common things that happens to, and we see this a lot with girl athletes, is that they'll be very low carb after they train, but they're tired, and after a while their menstrual cycles stop, or they start to spot, or they have brain fog, or they don't feel they have, they're more moody, and they out any longer periods of time, you see significant changes in their hormones in other areas. So the perception of carbs being bad and unneeded, the evidence doesn't support that. It says the opposite.
All right, well, I had a couple conversations today, and I'm explaining to people, you know, they're athletes, some of these guys, I said, hey, go check out some Botargo. You know, I explained the clinical research, but they said, well, why can't I do fruit? Why can't I have a strawberry? And I explained to them, look, fruit's not available. It's got to go through a couple different digestive systems before it's available in the body, unlike Botargo that is available in about 10 to 20 minutes. And that's why you literally take it at the gym, or you can take an intra-workout, because it's available very, very soon to the body to use as full. Is that correct?
Well, I would counter with this question. So if you don't want to use fruit or whole food, okay, then why aren't you eating a piece of steak or a chicken breast instead of your whey protein? And the common answer is, well, whey protein's better.
Good one.
Really? Well, if it's better, then why would you choose an inferior food?
All right.
Why don't you just drink milk or non-fat dry milk powder? Because that's cheap, too. And it's nearly pure protein. A little bit of fat, a little bit of sugars. Well, you have this double standard. So for us, it's just a matter of education. And so we believe, based upon research in muscle biopsies and more studies, we just finished a study at a U.S. university comparing Botargo Post, Botargo in a hydrolyzed whey that's been delactosed, against the same amount of protein from a hydrolyzed whey from a national brand, just the protein alone. Because the perception is, well, after I train, all I want is protein, and then I'll eat my carbs a couple hours later. Let's see what happens to body composition and strength if you do that over 8 weeks. And we did that study. The results are very intriguing.
They're coming out?
They'll be coming out in a few months.
Guys, I've been working with Botargo for a while. I'm trying to be at my potential. I'm really, you know, above all, we want to work with great companies, but we also want to be the best, and that dream means more than any revenue. And I chose to align myself with these guys I've been fortunate to. And even in this interview, even in taking a little bit of Anthony's time, and he's a busy man, he still surprised me with some of his analogies and ways he works things. Anthony, we really appreciate your time, buddy, and looking forward to that study coming out.
Thank you, Dave. My pleasure. Very much.
Cheers, buddy.